morning to everyone, and welcome to Monday morning prayer. I'd like to welcome everybody this morning, especially those that are not logged in today, and all those that are logged in. We begin this morning with our lighted candle. If you'd like to light a candle and join us, we'll light a candle for global peace and inter-spiritual unity. In the name of our beloved Father, Mother, God, who creates life. In the name of the risen cosmic Christ, who loves life. In the name of the Spirit, who is the fire of life. In the name of Gaia, who is the earth mother that nurtures the creation of all life. In the name of all faith traditions, who are the beloved sons and daughters of the divine life. We celebrate our spiritual diversity by honouring the Supreme in all life. And we say this morning, be still and aware of God's presence within and without. Excuse me. So we'll continue this morning with the prologue to the Monday morning communions. I enter the eternal and infinite garden with reverence to the Heavenly Father and Earthly Mother and Great Masters, reverence to the holy, pure and saving teachings, reverence to the brotherhood and the sisterhood of the elect. Monday morning we commune with the Angel of Life, saying, Angel of Life, enter my limbs and give strength to my whole body. As you now contemplate the trees and feel yourselves absorbing vital healing energy forces from the trees and the forests of the Creator's garden. So let's just think of the Creator's garden and the trees and the forest this morning. And let's thank the Lord for our life and our breath today. Just think of the Creator's garden. Now I'd like to pray the prayer of protection this morning. In the name of the risen cosmic Christ, I draw bloodline by faith around the Teyu community this morning, around each one of us online today, around our health, our finance, our homes, our partners, our families, our life's work and friends and clients. We draw bloodline by faith, knowing that there is power, wondrous power in the precious blood, of the risen cosmic Christ. And neither Satan nor any of his co-workers or dark energies or entities can ever cross such a bloodline. Amen. Now we'll stop for a few moments and think of the things that might be troubling us today. And we just hand them over to Christ this morning, or to your higher power today. And we say, in the comforts of your love, I pour out to you, my Saviour, the memories that haunt me, the anxieties that perplex me, the fears that stifle me, the sickness that prevails upon me, the frustration of all the pain that weaves about within me. Lord, help me to see your peace in my turmoil, your compassion in my sorrow, your forgiveness in my weakness, your love in my need. Touch us, O Lord, this morning with your healing power and with your strength, so that we may be able to return to you, children of God, whole, perfect and complete. Amen. And now we come to the exile's nostalgia for the Lord's temple, Psalm 42. Like the deer that yearns for the running stream, so my soul is yearning for you, my God. My soul is thirsting for God, the God of my life. When can I see and enter the face of God? These tears have become my bread by night and by day, as I hear it said all day long, where is your God? These things will I remember as I pour out my soul. How I would lead the rejoicing crowd into the house of God amid the cries of gladness and thanksgiving throng wild with joy. Why are you downcast, O my soul? Why groan within me? Hope in God, I will praise him still, my Saviour and my God. My soul is downcast within me, and I think of you from the country of Jordan, from Mount Hermon, from the hill of Mizar. Deep is calling on deep. In the roar of the mighty waters, your torrents and all your waves swept over me. By the day, the Lord will send his loving kindness. By the night, I will sing praise. Praise to the God of my life. I will say to God, my rock, why have you forgotten me? Why do I go into mourning oppressed by the foe? With cries that pierce me to the heart, my enemies revile me, saying to me all day long, where is your God? Why are you downcast, O my soul? Why groan within me? Hope in God. I will praise him still, my Saviour and my God. Amen. Now we have a scripture reading from Thessalonians. We gave you a rule when we were with you, not to let anyone have any food if he refused to do any work. Now we hear that there are some of you who are living in idleness, doing no work themselves, but interfering with everyone else. In the Lord Jesus Christ, we order and call on people of this kind to go on quietly working and earning the food they eat. My brothers and sisters, never grow tired of doing what is right. I'd like to say that again, because sometimes we do grow tired of doing what is right. My brothers and sisters, never grow tired of doing what is right. Now I'd like to share the Benedictus, the Canticle of Zechariah, and we do this every morning, so I'd like to share it with you. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel, for he has visited his people and redeemed them. He has raised up a mighty Saviour in the house of David his servant, as he has promised from the lips of holy men, those who were prophets from of old, a Saviour who would free us from our foes, from the hands of all who hate us. So his love for our Father is fulfilled, and his holy covenant remembered. He swore to Abraham our father to grant us that free from fear and safe from the hands of our enemies all the days of our life in his presence. As for you, little child, you shall be called the prophet of God the Most High. You shall go ahead of the Lord to prepare his way before him, to make known to his people their salvation through the forgiveness of all their sins, the loving kindness of the heart of our God, who visits us like a dawn from on high. He will give light to those who are in darkness, those who dwell in the shadow of death, and guide us into the new way of peace. I'd just like to say there that Jesus says he will shine his light into our lives and into our hearts and show us the way forward. And when I read that, he will give light to those who are in darkness, those who dwell in the shadow of death, and guide us into the new way of peace. I always try and imagine that the Lord filling me with light and shining his light upon my path. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Now I'd like to share a couple of little readings. It's from Doreen Virtue, a book by Doreen Virtue, and it's Daily Guidance from Your Angels. And I love to think of angels, and we do believe in angels, because angels cross all religions, and it doesn't matter what religion you are, you can believe in angels. So this is from the angels this morning. I'd just like to share couple of little readings that, if I can find it, that's it. The first one is, put the situation in God's hands. The best way to resolve a situation that stirs worry and anger in you is to give it to God. Today, put what's bothering you into the Creator and the Creator's ready and able hands. You don't need to go through it alone. ever. Stewing over a situation makes it more combustible. Releasing the situation to God means that you will be settled in a miraculous, harmonious way. It also frees you from a toxic effect of stress and rage. If you need help letting go, please call upon the angels. We'll never interfere with your free will, but we can aid you in seeing the light of all the peaceful options that are available to you. And the little thought for today is, I put this situation in God's hands. I trust that Heaven's wisdom will deal with the problem completely, and I release all negative thoughts or feelings. I know that this issue is already perfectly resolved right now in truth. And then I'd like to share this one, which for me, it follows on. It's saying, trust that your prayers are being answered. So we have to put the prayers into God's hands, and then we have to trust that God is answering our prayer. God and the angels are answering our prayers. So it says, although you may not see the results, your prayers are being answered. The universe is currently working behind the scenes on your behalf, and the manifestation of your desire is imminent. Your role in the meantime is to maintain faith and follow your inner guidance. The rest is up to God and the angels. We're very happy to work to support you in the name of love and peace. As you ascend in happiness, we're elevated right along with you. So is it any wonder that we work diligently to boost your joy? This is the angels speaking. God will radiate like beams of sun, ensuring elation for all. As we guide you along the warm pathways of love and answer your prayers spring up before you like flowers. I think that's lovely. Just imagine the spring and the flowers coming up and popping up in spring. You know, the snowdrops and the crocuses. And just imagine the flowers popping up. And now when we plant seeds, we're always watching for the seeds to grow before they grow, and we get impatient, but the seeds pop up and they grow. And that's what it's like with God answering our prayers. And the thoughts for today is, all my prayers are heard and answered. I trust and have faith that they are manifesting into form right now. I release any worries or fears to God and the angels, for I trust the Spirit to perfectly take care of all the details. I think that's lovely. So I just felt to share that this morning. So now we come to intercessions this morning. And I'd like to pray, Heavenly Father, Earthly Mother God, we pray this morning for all those online today. We pray for all those that are not logged in today. And we pray this morning for Brother Sean and for Jeannie, for Lisa, for Father Richard, and for all those that may have joined us online this morning. So I pray, Heavenly Father, Earthly Mother God, we pray this morning for the TU community. We pray for all its members, past and present, and we pray for each one of us today. And I have quite a long list, so I hope you'll bear with me this morning, because I like to go through and pray for people personally, because I think it means quite a lot. I'd like to pray for Brother Sean this morning. We ask a blessing upon Brother Sean today, and we ask for health and strength. And we pray for this thing that he has with Pip. We just pray for that everything will work out. And we pray also for Brother Rob. We just ask a blessing upon Brother Rob today. And we pray for Brother Mary and for Brother Paul today, and for Brother Paul's wife. And I'd like to pray for Sister Olivia and for Teresa today. We pray today also for Sister Elaine, for Laura, and for Sister Miriam New Zealand today. We pray for them today. And I pray for Elizabeth and Eleanor today. We just ask a blessing upon Sister Eleanor that she will be able to continue with prayers. And I'd like to thank you, Lord, that as Brother Sean was saying the other day, that Elizabeth has turned a corner. So we just pray that you will continue to bless her, Lord. And we pray also today for, I pray for Ben and Paul, my friend Paul, and for Em and for their family. I pray for them today. And also I pray for Will and Pat and Tony today, and for Kath. I'd like to pray particularly for Will because he's found out that he's got lung cancer. And we just pray that, you know, that he'll be brave and that if there's anything that they can do for him, they'll be able to do it. And we just pray that that you'll help him to be brave at this time and have courage. We pray that, that he'll have courage. And I'd like to also pray for Brother Paul, US, and for Mary Gates today. And we pray today for Sister Nancy, Lisa, Sheila, Jeannie and family, and for Harry. We pray for Harry. And we just pray that, Lord, you will shine your light into Harry's life. And you will show him the way forward, Lord, today. And I pray for all those that are being drawn, and for the four that are, for the four that are being coming into the community. We pray for them today. Lord, you know each one of them this morning. And we pray today, I pray today for Father Richard. We just ask a blessing upon Father Richard. I'd like to pray for my granddaughter Beth and for my daughter Sarah and for all the family. And I just pray for Gordon today, who has overcome cancer 3 times. We've had him on our prayer list for quite a few years and he's overcome cancer 3 times. So we just thank you, Lord, that you do answer prayer. And we just ask a blessing upon him today. And we pray today also for Elsie and for Elsie's daughter Jane. And for Richard too. We pray for Richard. And we pray for all our friends and prayer partners of the Tayu community today. And I'd just like to mention Kathy, who is going blind. We pray for Kathy, one of Brother Sean's neighbours. We just pray for her today. And we pray for all our neighbours. And I've heard that one of my neighbours has died this week. And we just pray for his soul. It's Morris. And I just pray for Morris that his soul may rest in peace. And we just pray for all those that have passed away who are close to us. We pray that their souls may rest in peace. I'd like to also pray for Brother Sean's brother, who I think he's got cancer. We pray for Brother Sean's brother, Shay. We pray for him today, and we just ask, Lord, that you will lay your healing hand upon him, Lord, and you will give him your health and strength. But most of all, I pray that you will give him your courage, because I know when my auntie died of cancer beginning of last year, she had so much courage. She was told she had 3 months to live, and she had so much courage. And I think it's important, you know, that we put things right when we get near to the end of our life, and that we have courage. I think courage is a very important thing. And I'd like to pray also for all the requests on the chat board this morning. We just pray for each one of us this morning. We pray today for all those in troubled places in the world. We pray that their souls, we just pray that their people will be touched with the love of God today. And we pray that for the peace in Syria, we pray that this peace will hold and that the people in Syria will be set free, from the things that are causing all the trouble. We just pray, Lord, that you will help in this situation, Lord, and you will work in many mysterious ways. We pray for a unity of all faith. We just pray today for people to come together in love. And we pray for Pope Francis, and we pray for all the leaders of the churches, and we just pray that they'll come together in love. Pray for those with serious illnesses and incurable diseases today, Lord, especially those suffering with cancer. And those with heart disease today, and I think of our James there, because our James has got heart failure, and we just pray for our James today. And I would like to thank everybody for praying for myself and for my family and for our James, because he has come round, and he seems to be quite a bit better at the moment. He's coping better, should I say, that's it. And we'd pray today for all those that have nobody to pray for them. And we pray for all those that are lost and feel unloved today, that someone will reach out their hand and help them today. For all our pets today, we pray today, Lord, and we just ask a blessing upon all our pets. And I ask a blessing upon Cheeky and Toby. And it's quite hilarious with Cheeky, the one that I fostered, Cheeky, the little Senegal parrot, because she does an imitation of the telephone. And it's quite hilarious. When I go out of the room, if she wants me attention, she does the imitation of the telephone. So it's quite hilarious. So they are lovely, our pets, and they bring us a lot of joy. And we just ask a blessing upon our pets today. I'd like to pray the prayer that Jesus taught us to pray. Heavenly Father, earthly Mother God, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil today. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. And while I was praying there, I just remembered to pray for Skip this morning. We just ask a blessing upon Skip and upon all those that watch on social media today. And all those that may watch the recordings, we pray for them today. And I'd like to just ask you, Lord, to fill us afresh with your Holy Spirit this morning. We pray, breathe on us, breath of God, fill our hearts with life anew, that we might love what thou dost love and do what thou wouldst do. Touch our lives, Lord, that we might see you in everything that lives and moves and as it's been from you this day. Empower us, Lord, to live in the present moment, seeking only your love and light. Amen. So I'd just like to thank you all for being with us this morning, and we especially thank the Lord for answered prayer. And we just hand over anything that might be troubling us this morning. I realise I didn't give you a quiet time this morning. So we just hand over anything that's troubling us today, and we let go and let God today. So I'd like to thank you for being with us this morning. And if it's evening where you are, have a good night's sleep. And if it's daytime, have a great day. We'll say blessings and peace. We say blessings and peace, everyone. I just forgot. Bear with me. I just forgot. I'm rushing this morning. I just forgot. We blow out the candle and we send love, light, blessing and peace to all those troubled places in the world, and we blow love to one another. Amen. Have to just bear with us sometimes. I know Brother Sean will probably find the same thing, that when you're doing prayers, you seem to lose track of, when you're praying, you seem to lose track of your thoughts sometimes. So just bear with us. So I say blessings and peace, everyone.